Hello again. Okay, are you ready? Are you ready? All right. Two of my friends were born on the same day. Eso pasa. Two of my friends. Dos de mis amigos. O sea, dos amigos míos. También podríamos decir two friends of mine. Dos amigos de los míos. Two friends of mine. Two of my friends. Three of my friends. 10 of my friends. All of my friends, none of my friends, two of my friends were born. Yeah, fueron dados a luz. O sea, nacieron. Were born. B muy dura, una B durísima. Ba 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 baran. Born. Two of my friends were born on the same day, on the same day, on Monday, on Tuesday, on the 21st, on Saturday. Yes. On the same day. Cuando es un solo día, on, nunca en. On the same day.
Hola y bienvenidos a la clase 196. Ahora vamos a ver la frase. Two of my friends were born on the same day. Dos de mis amigos nacieron el mismo día. Y ahora nos centraremos en la primera parte de la frase. Two of my friends. Dos de mis amigos. Two. Eso es fácil, ¿no? Dos. Uno, one, dos, two. Fácil. Two of my friends. También recuerda que en inglés no cambiamos my para mys ni nada. Es two of my friends. Two of my friends, aunque sea plural. Two of my friends live on the same street as me. Dos de mis amigos viven en la misma calle que yo. Two of my friends work with me. Dos de mis amigos trabajan conmigo. Two of my friends. ¿Y la pronunciación de of cómo es? Muy bien, of no, of, casi como una V. Of, two of my friends. ¿Y si son tres? Three of my friends. Perfecto, ¿y si son 97? 97 of my friends. Muy, muy bien.
Finished another program. It's technology time. That's right. I'm the best at creating programs that teach languages. For example, this program teaches languages, and two of my friends have learned German. Two of my friends have learned German with this program. Dos de mis amigos. Two of my friends. Two of my friends have learned German with this system. Two of my friends. Three of my friends have learned Chinese with the same system. With the same system. Two of my friends have learned Chinese. Four of my friends have learned Russian. Now I can speak in Russian on the computer, chatting with my friends, because four of them speak Russian. It's wonderful. Four of them speak Russian. One of them speaks Chinese. It's incredible. One of my friends speaks Chinese. All because of my program and my baby that I created. I'm pretty proud of it.
Entonces, dos de mis amigos, two of my friends, y dos de tus amigos, two of your friends. Muy bien. Two of my friends were born. Nacieron en plural, were, no was. Were born, porque siempre decimos to be born, y no born, a secas. To be born, en pasado, they, plural, were born. Muy bien. Two of my friends were born in May. Dos de mis amigos nacieron en mayo. Two of my friends were born in Chile. Dos de mis amigos nacieron en Chile. Two of my friends were born on the same day. Dos de mis amigos nacieron en el mismo día. What a, la palabra del día, what a coincidence. ¡Qué casualidad! Coincidence, es una palabra buenísima. Coincidence. Cuatro sílabas, pronúncialos bien. Coincidence. Muy bien, y no decimos coincidence. Coincidence, casualidad. Y tampoco decimos casualty. Eso es otra cosa, eso es una víctima de un accidente. Coincidence, coincidence. Dilo otra vez. Coincidence. What a coincidence.
Dos amigas mías que nacieron en Argentina quieren visitar su lugar de nacimiento. Y voy con ellas. Yay! Well, they were born in Argentina. I wasn't born in Argentina. They were born in Argentina. De hecho, nacieron en la ciudad de Buenos Aires. That's it. They were born in Buenos Aires. Say it with me. They were born in Buenos Aires. No, they borned. They were born in Buenos Aires, okay? Bueno, they were born in Buenos Aires, pero crecieron en los Estados Unidos. Por eso les conozco. Así que they don't speak Spanish. Tendré que hablar yo. Por ellas. Uf, tengo que practicar. Che boludos. Las chicas nacieron acá. They were born here. Pero yo nací allá. I was born there. Oh my God! I have a perfect Argentinian accent. So exciting!
What a coincidence. They were both born, two of my friends were born on the same day. El mismo día, on the same day. On es la preposición que usamos aquí y no in. On the, sacando la lengua, on the same day. Eso, on the same day. Entonces, veamos más ejemplos con on the same day. My two friends, they have the same birthday, tienen el mismo cumpleaños, pero, but, they don't like to celebrate on the same day. A ellos no les gustan, no les gusta celebrar en el mismo día. They don't like to celebrate on the same day. What a coincidence that they have the same birthday, ¿no? ¡Qué casualidad! Remember, no decimos what a casualty. No, la palabra del día, coincidence. Y ahora, la frase entera. A ver si lo puedes traducir bien. Dos de mis amigos nacieron el mismo día. Dilo sin error. Two of my friends were born on the same day. ¡Qué bien! ¿Y? ¡Vaya coincidencia! ¡Vaya casualidad! Te daba una pista. What a coincidence.
How exciting! O sea, I mean, it's Funchi's birthday tomorrow. Tomorrow? Yeah. It's her birthday. Ah, y lo mejor es que Jennifer's birthday is tomorrow too. Their birthdays are on the same day. En el mismo día. On the same day. Can you believe that? Mira, como digo, en el mismo día. On the same day. Dices con on o con in, on, the same, acabando así, m, day. On the same day. Repite. That's right. Pues se lo tengo que decir, se lo tengo que decir que se van a poner súper contentas. Funchi, ¿alguien sabe qué? Your birthday is on the same day as Jennifer's birthday. I know. Isn't that amazing? Sí, se lo voy a decir a ella también. Ok, bye. Es que me aburro mogollón. Jennifer, can you believe it? Your birthday is on the same day as Fuji's. Yes, write it down. Apúntatelo por ahí, ya verás qué guay. Ok, bye. O sea, pues eso. Fuji's birthday and Jennifer's birthday is on the same day. So I have to buy two presents. Ok.
Hello again, welcome back. Are you ready? Okay, listen to this sentence. I lent him quite a lot of money. Quite a lot of money, or quite a bit of money. But he hasn't paid me back yet. Okay, le presté. El verbo prestar is to lend, con D. Pasado y participio lent, L-E-N-T, lent. I lent him. No, I lent to him. I lent her. I lent you. I lent them. I lent him quite a bit of money, bastante dinero, or quite a lot of money. Ambos nos valen. I lent him quite a lot of money. Quite a lot of, quite a bit of, bastante dinero. I lent him quite a bit of money. I lent him quite a lot of money. Pero no me ha devuelto lo prestado todavía. But he hasn't paid me back yet. He hasn't paid me back yet. He hasn't paid me back yet. He owes me the money. He hasn't paid me back yet.
Hola.
Hola, bienvenidos a la clase número 196. Y la frase de hoy es... I lent him quite a lot of money, but he hasn't paid me back yet. En español, le presté bastante dinero, pero no me lo ha devuelto todavía. Bien, vamos con la primera parte. Lent. Es decir, presté. Ahora, cuidado con to lend. To lend es el infinitivo, que es prestar. Es decir, dar prestado. Y no lo confundamos con to borrow. A ver, acuérdate. To lend es dar prestado. Mientras que to borrow es coger prestado. Bien. Ahora, to lend es un verbo irregular. Por lo tanto, every day I lend y yesterday I lent. Muy bien, con la T y marcándola bien. Lent, lent. Vamos a ver algunos ejemplos. You still have my pen. I lent it to you, remember? Y ahora, the last time I lent him something, he gave it back to me damaged. Y aquí tenemos la palabra del día, damaged, que es roto o estropeado. Muy bien, nos vemos en un minuto.
You've only read the first chapter. I lent you the book 4 weeks ago, Bob. ¿Cuándo me lo va a devolver? When are you going to give it me back? I lent it to you 4 weeks ago, Bob. Hurry up. Bob is so lazy. I lent him a book a month ago and he's only read the first chapter. Se lo presté. I lent it to him and not borrowed. The verb is to lend something to someone. I lent the book to him or I lent him the book. How long does it take to read a book? You know, I lent him a book last year and it took him 3 months to read it. God, I even lent him a DVD and it took him 2 months to watch it. Well, that's the last time I lend him anything. Anyway, I always lend him things and he never lends me anything. That reminds me, actually, Bob. Bob, do you remember that 2 euros that I lent you a while ago? Yes, I lent you 2 euros at the cinema. Well, I need it back. I didn't give it you, Bob. I lent it to you.
Vamos con la segunda parte de la frase de hoy, que es quite a lot of money. En español, bastante dinero. Bien, ahora, money, acordaros que es incontable. Así que usamos quite a lot of. No decimos nunca quite a few money, uf, suena fatal, sino quite a lot of, bastante. Bien, ahora cuidado con la pronunciación, que no es money o money, sino money, money. Funny money, funny money, honey. Todo rima, ¿verdad? Bien, vamos a ver algunos ejemplos. He earns quite a lot of money. The wedding cost quite a lot of money. He lent me quite a lot of money. Me prestó bastante dinero. But I've already paid him back. Otro ejemplo. Wow, that's quite a lot of money. You didn't have to lend me so much. I really appreciate it. Muy bien hecho. Nos vemos en la siguiente parte.
You know, planning a wedding costs quite a lot of money. The wedding costs quite a lot of money. Everything these days costs quite a lot of money, but especially a wedding. Yeah, I had to buy my suit. At Sarah's shop, it costs quite a lot of money. That's right, we say quite a lot of, quite a lot of, and linking the sounds together, quite a lot of money, quite a lot of. Yeah, also the wedding cake cost quite a lot of money. Very expensive, actually. Weddings in general, I mean, the clothes cost quite a lot of money, the rings cost quite a lot of money, the cake cost quite a lot of money. Well, at least I have this painting. This is a real masterpiece, one of my originals. And Pierre has agreed to lend me quite a lot of money in exchange for this painting. I'll pay him back, but at least I'll have the money for now. Because weddings, they need quite a lot of money.
Bien, vamos con la tercera parte de la frase de hoy, que es hasn't paid me back. En español, no me lo ha devuelto. Ahora aquí tenemos el phrasal verb, el verbo compuesto to pay back, que quiere decir devolver el dinero, omitiendo la palabra money, ya que se entiende. Bien, y esto es un verbo irregular, to pay, que es every day I pay him back, yesterday I paid him back, y lately I've paid him back. Muy bien. Ahora cuidado, porque ponemos el him entre paid y back. No decimos pay back him. Puf, suena fatal, sino que ponemos el pronombre entre el verbo y la preposición. Bien, vamos a ver algunos ejemplos. He hasn't paid her back yet, and she's getting impatient. He hasn't paid back what he owes me. He's been paying the bank back for the loan. He's been paying it back for 7 years. Muy bien hecho. Nos vemos en la siguiente clase.
You know, I'm sick of that lazy Steve. I lent him quite a bit of money last week, and he hasn't even paid me back yet. Don't tell me you don't know who Steve is. That lazy guy from the information desk? Yeah, last week I lent him quite a bit of money, and he hasn't paid me back yet. I knew it was a mistake, because he never pays anybody back. Yeah. Aún no me ha devuelto el dinero. He hasn't paid me back yet. He hasn't paid me back yet. That's right. He told me he only needed a few days for the money. But now it's a week. Today it's midday, and he still hasn't paid me back yet. Yo soy muy generosa. I'm very generous. But I mean, I hate it when people don't pay me back. I'm gonna call him and tell him he needs to pay me back. Hello, Steve. I need you to pay me back. Well, okay. He said he hasn't paid me back yet because he hasn't been paid yet. I'm gonna go get my 5 euros back.
Hello, welcome back. Okay, this sentence is a bit, well, not difficult, but it's interesting. It was pointless. It was pointless trying to do him a favor. It didn't make any difference. It was pointless. Era una pérdida de tiempo. Era inútil intentar hacerle un favor a ese tío. Daba igual. It didn't make any difference. It didn't matter. It didn't make any difference. Literalmente, no hizo, no hacía ninguna diferencia. Pero significa daba igual. Hubiera dado igual. It didn't make any difference. It didn't make any difference. It was pointless, al principio de la frase. Point, it was pointless. La expresión to be pointless es inútil. Una acción que no sirve para nada. Yes. No sirvió para nada. O no servía para nada hacerle un favor. It was pointless. It was pointless trying to do him. Intentar hacerle. Trying to do him a favor. Do me a favor. Do them a favor. Excuse me. Can you do me a favor? Bah. It's pointless trying to do him a favor. It doesn't make any difference. Hello again. Welcome back for a new class. All right. The sentence is the following. It was pointless trying to do him a favor. It didn't make any difference. It was pointless trying to do him a favor. It didn't make any difference. It was pointless, pointless, pointless. Era inútil. Yeah, una pérdida de tiempo. El intentar hacerle un favor. Daba igual. It didn't make any difference. Era lo mismo. Le era lo mismo. Le era indiferente. Yeah, it was pointless. Point is un punto, punto, point. Pointless is inútil en el sentido de perder tiempo. Un objeto is useless. Un calendario viejo is useless. Pero una actividad inútil is pointless. Una acción. It was pointless trying. Era inútil intentar, ni intentar hacerle un favor. It was pointless trying. It's pointless trying to learn English only studying vocabulary. It's pointless trying to learn English only concentrating on advanced grammar. It's pointless trying to learn English reading high-level literature. It's pointless trying to learn English only studying grammar theory. It's completely pointless.
I feel really bad. Yeah, I feel bad. Me siento culpable. Cuidado, es un error común. No me siento bien es I don't feel well. Pero I feel bad es culpabilidad. No tiene nada que ver con físico. So I feel bad, well, for getting even with Mike. For being vengeful, vengativo. Yeah, I'm not a vengeful person. What was I thinking? Oh, man, it was pointless trying to get even with him. It was pointless. I mean, the idea is to make friends, not to make enemies. Man, it was pointless trying to get revenge and trying to get even. It was pointless to try and make another enemy. Yeah, totally pointless. Yeah, no servía de nada. No sirve de nada. It's pointless. Yeah, it's pointless. What's the point? ¿De qué sirve? What's the point of getting angry? ¿De qué sirve enfadarse? It's pointless. No sirve de nada. Right? Practica eso en casa. What's the point of... Y pon lo que quieras. What's the point of getting angry? Siempre con el gerundio. What's the point of fighting all the time? ¿De qué sirve pelear siempre? What's the point? It's pointless. We need to be friends. We need to get along. Nos tenemos que llevar bien. Mike, me, and all the rest of the colleagues.
Hello again. Part two. It's pointless trying to do him a favor. It doesn't make any difference to him. No le importa un comino, eh? It's pointless. Es una pérdida de tiempo intentar hacerle un favor. It's pointless trying. To do him a favor, to do him a favor, do me a favor. El verbo to do, cuando hacemos favores, es to do. Hazme, do me, do him, hazle, do him a favor, do her a favor, do, I'll do you a favor, do them a favor, do us a favor. Okay? So it's pointless trying to do him a favor. It doesn't make any difference to him. And the word of the day is una palabra con guión. Quick, como rápido, witted, como de mente rápida, reflejos espabilado, ocurrente, una persona de rápidos reflejos mentales. Wow, este tipo es listo, espabilado, agudo. He's quick-witted. W-I-T-T-E-D, witted. Wit is la mente en su capacidad para ser ocurrente y rápido en sus reflejos. Wit. And quick-witted. Quick-witted es alguien espabilado, ocurrente, agudo. Yes, quick-witted.
Honestly, some people don't appreciate anything I do for them. I was only trying to do him a favor. Mike, I'm talking about Mike. I was only trying to do him a favor. What was I doing? What was I trying to do? Exactly. I was only trying to do him a favor. And he doesn't appreciate anything. Well, okay, maybe I shouldn't have, but I was only trying to do him a favor. You know, I wanted to tell Anna that Mike is in love with her. He's much too proud to do it himself, so I thought I'd do it for him. Well, it was pointless trying to do him a favor. He got so angry with me. If only he'd tell me why she's so angry. You know, he loves her, and I'm sure that she loves him too. Well, that's it. That's the last time I try to do anyone in this hotel a favor. Margaret is not doing favors for anyone ever again, and that's that.
All right, welcome back. Part three of our sentence. It was pointless, inútil intentar, bueno, cualquier cosa con él, porque no, to do him a favor, hacerle un favor. It was pointless, trying to do him a favor. It didn't make any difference. It didn't make any difference. To make a difference, it doesn't make, vamos en el presente. Da igual. It doesn't matter. It doesn't make any difference. Daba igual. It didn't matter. It didn't make any difference. It doesn't make any difference. Dará igual, ya verás. It won't matter. It won't make any difference. Se dice tanto, make any difference, que matter. Todo el mundo sabe it doesn't matter. Da igual, it doesn't matter. Pero también se dice igual de frecuente. It doesn't make any difference. O bien, it makes no difference. Ahora estamos en el presente, escuchad. Da igual. It makes no, en ello. It makes no difference. Or it doesn't make any difference. Pasado. Daba igual. It didn't make any difference. Dará igual, ya verás. It won't make any difference, or it'll make no difference. It won't make any... Doesn't make any difference. Doesn't make any difference. No, it doesn't make any difference. And yesterday, it didn't make any difference.
Well, I'm sorry, George. I gave you my advice. I tried to help. I'm sorry. Hey, how's it going? That was George again. You know, it was pointless trying to help him. It was pointless giving him my advice. He says it hasn't made any difference at all. But I tried my best. That's what he says. It hasn't made any difference at all. Repeat it with me. It hasn't made any difference at all. Apparently, he went on a date last night and he followed my advice. He took her flowers, he paid for the meal, he even used a few of my chat-up lines. But he said it didn't make any difference at all. I don't understand. Poor George. You know, maybe no matter how much I give him advice, maybe it will never make any difference at all. Maybe no matter what I say, it's gonna make a difference with George. I think there's a normal way of doing things and then there's a mic, the machine way of doing things. And if George wants my advice to make any difference at all, he has to do it my way. Then it's highly likely it will make a big, big difference.